There's the phthalo blue, there's the brown, and I want to build up here some color.
The master at work, Barry Burdeny, explains his vision of Prairie Sonata.
Let's have a look at the painting. This is the sky, wind, clouds, the grain field, the flowers at the edge of the grain field, the ditch coming into the road, but I wanted to go below the soil and show the aquifer of water, and then the dark, which in this case, Alberta, would be the bitumen, which of course the tar sands are all the reason to be. And I just want to darken this up. So when you stand back, this comes forward. This comes right toward you. And I find that instead of just using a plain Van Dyke or burnt umber brown, I add blue to it to give it a little more heft. You see, now this, when you stand back, the texture of the palette knife stands out a little more than it did before when we first had a look at it before I added it, the colors. I'm also going to take, you see, a brush gives a different feel. A palette knife, you see? Now, what I can do is I can leave that there dry, and then I can take a little bit of color, light brown, gray, and go across the surface once it's dry, and that's called scumbling. This is what I've done here. That is actually dry, and then I've taken mauve and blue and scumbled, and then I've taken some yellow and scumbled onto the surface. So this gives a general idea of how I work the basis of a painting to tell a story.
Burdeny has a fine arts degree from the Ontario College of Art, spent 3 years at the prestigious Slade School in London, England, and then completed his master's at the Art Institute of Chicago. You won't find his art in any galleries, though. Burdeny prefers a more personal touch.
I was very much influenced by the French Impressionists in Chicago. They have a huge collection of Monets and Sisleys and Pissarros. And from that, I started to show art in Toronto privately, corporately. And what I did was I would contact the president of a corporation by letter, by hand. I'd write a handwritten letter. And a lot got thrown out, but some didn't.
Burdeny sold his first piece of art when he was 12 years old for $12. Now his paintings can be found around the world.
Creating is for me second nature, and it's not work. I come out to my studio in the morning, put on classical music, and can paint all day. Having my work hanging in a personal or private collection or a corporate collection is an affirmation of someone saying, your art speaks to me. And that is a joy too.
For Go Winnipeg, I'm Tracy Koga.